Hey folks, my name is Richard, and for the last year I have been the headmaster of the Academy of Adventures, an after-school and summer camp for kids ages 11 to 15 where you learn how to play Dungeons & Dragons online. And in that year, I think I've learned quite a few tricks, and I wanted to take a moment and just kind of share three of them with you and give you kind of a sense about some of the things that you can use to really, really run RPGs with kids successfully. And of those three, of course, they may not be true for every kid, just like DMing for any group. Depends on your group composition and things like that. But these three have all been pretty darn positive. The first one is getting a little bit wacky. And by this, I do not mean Daffy Duck, although I do mean cartoons a little bit. If you think about the way cartoons are set up, right? So they've got these huge overarching storylines that are totally vague, right? I remember from being a kid, He-Man dislikes Skeletor. They have a fight. What's the fight about? We'll figure it out. When are we going to get there? Someday. But today, we have a complete story in this episode. We're going to work through, you know, all the way from the beginning to the conclusion, and it's going to be pretty, pretty set and done. And at the end of it, I know there's still Skeletor out there. I know I've got motion to go, but I'm not really going to dig into this huge, cool, intricate storyline, right? Let's keep it all together right here in one day. Speaking of number two, I'm going to need you to focus on the chaos that's going to come up in any game session with kids, right? Not just because kids are energetic, but yeah, there's huge energy all the time. You got to like build that, harness it, adapt it, like make it part of your game. And that kind of means that in a lot of ways, you as a storyteller need to be ready for all sorts of improvisation. Just be prepared to go anywhere because the story could go anywhere pretty quickly. You could try to keep things on rails, but just embrace it, like dig in. Make encounters that are easy to pick up and move to other locations. Make NPCs that could show up anywhere. Like if you need a scholar for your story, make sure that scholar doesn't just have to exist at this specific, you know, arcane college, but allow them to go anywhere that the kids want to find this scholar. This kind of like ease to move around your storyline is so fantastic, and it makes it so that you can allow your kids that bit of agency. So allowing this game to harness that, to give people options and let people make choices that they couldn't make in their life otherwise, is a huge deal. In the exact same vein, you also want to use your own experience to make sure you keep the story moving forward. We know that using moments of calm, like, you know, long sets of questions are cool for figuring out a whole lot of things, but they can get boring real quick, especially if your attention span is not really ready for this huge, you know, Q&A session. Whenever you get bored in there, whenever you get bored, probably someone else is, just throw in some action. Don't get to that moment when everyone's like, okay, any other questions? Anyone else? Anyone? No? Okay. Long before then, someone's walked in or something's happened outside, right? We're going to move our action forward. And by doing that, we keep our attention, we keep our focus, and we keep everything exciting and engaging. And with kids, that's a huge deal. The last one I want to do is think a little bit about kids in general, right? I run games for kids that are ages 11 to 15, which is this really important time for young people to build their problem-solving skills, their analytical skills, right? And that's because, adults have a lot more experience. They may be able to piece things together really well. And that's something to be cognizant of when you're teaching and working with a group. I usually work with new kids almost every week. But if you have the same group and you can really dig in and know where everyone is at, it's a fantastic way to approach a young group of kids. You can almost look at the Common Core standards and see exactly how they're going to apply to your D&D table to give you a sense of how to move your own game forward and how to create a story that applies that to them. Do you want to know what their logic skills are like? Common Core's got a reasonable understanding by grade level, so feel free to check that stuff out. These are my three kind of tips for working with kids, three simple ones to get you started. Of course, if you are interested in learning more, I am currently running the Academy of Adventures Summer Camp Kickstarter, and if you've got kids out there ages 11 to 15 who are learning to play D&D and want to find a bigger adventure, you can have them join us for sure. And beyond that, just make sure that you are playing great games with kids, like activate them. It's so good. It's such a positive experience. And I hope you have a great time running more games with kids. Take care.